It all started while prototyping this guy, a step sensor for another project. Prototypes are great because they reveal your mistakes, your bad decisions. So I knew there will be a second version, but I still had this guy which works and looks pretty cool in a dim lighting. And since I play bass in a punk fusion band, it only made sense to turn it into a stage prop. It serves two functions, sensor input and light feedback. The sensor in itself is a typical velostat sandwich, then on top comes the light emitting part. First a thin white layer serving as a reflector, then the transparent light guy that gets edge lit, another white layer as a diffuser. I added another extra transparent layer for protection, might be excessive though. I won't go into too much detail on the step sensor in this video, but make sure to leave a comment if you'd be interested in that. Okay, cool, but what does this have to do with bass playing? I'm glad I asked. Let me introduce this very cool pedal from Darkglass. They make awesome bass pedals, not sponsored or anything, just a fan. I want to be able to trigger it using the step sensor. Some pedals use latching switches, but this one uses a momentary switch with extra logic, like debouncing. So to make it work, I need a bit of logic myself besides the relay. My approach is a minimally invasive procedure, soldering as little as possible to the board. I'll expose a new connector that simply overrides the foot switch. For that, I'm using a magnetic pogo connector like this one. They're pretty cool and not as fragile as others their size. Now I need to butcher a slot. Luckily, there's enough space for that. Good thing you can't see the nervousness on my face. I start by carefully measuring and squaring everything until I'm not so sure anymore. Then it's time for the combo of champions. Pray and drill. Pray and drill. Praying never really helped me, so now try to drill at an angle to rectify. CNCs, I know they exist, but I need to have this done in time for the next small gig that's days away. It's gonna be manual. Very manual. I feel a compulsive need to vacuum because I imagine metal shavings stuck on the PCB and in between the pins of the ICs. Just stuff of nightmares. This is pretty much where simple holes can get me. I could get a tad further if I abuse that drill bit a little. It's not like I don't have other tools, just not proper tools.
No, no, no. No, no, no.
So, sorry, not sorry, drill bit. That's it. Speaking of appropriate tools, since this is a box, I'm using a box cutter. What do you think, just because it's made of aluminium it's gonna give up on me? No, it's gonna push through. Be like the box cutter, and not like the idiot trying to use it for this job. I'll gladly take the roast, so please leave any snarky comments below, I would love to read them. But in the end I got there. Yay!
It works, so.
Quick solder job. This pad has a big copper pore, so it's a bit trickier, but nothing too dramatic. Alright, checkpoint time. I want to make sure that the pedal still works at this point. Good news, original button works, and the new connector does too. Next, I 3D printed a bracket to hold the connector firmly by two screws, and there's not enough space for that. I made another one with only one screw in the center. Drill away. precision is not the name of the game here. I had to make the screw pointy to be able to get it in. It's water under the bridge now. It's all water under the bridge, and the bridge is crooked, and I also scratched the paint, but hey, it's done. It's done. Time for a full functionality test. The connector will be shorted by the relay for some milliseconds, then released, simulating a button press. A stomp, I mean. This happens once when I step on the pressure pad and once again when I step off. Ah, works well. I'll need to play with the time the relay stays close, see how low I can bring it while still satisfying the debounce time of the pedal. I'm at around 50 milliseconds now. I think I can get a bit lower. Next, I need to tackle the other side of the connector. I designed a little casing for the plug and 3D printed it, partly in TPU for some strain relief on the cable's flex point. The casing comes in two pieces and it's fastened by one screw. And that's enough. Now it's just a matter of soldering this telephone cable and putting the whole thing together. It does the job and I like how it looks.
Houston is go for final approach. Final approach has begun.
Contact, capture.
Soft capture confirmed.
Cheers all around the control room after that docking.
There is some more work to be done on the step sensor, namely edges. The whole sandwich fits perfectly by design in this aluminium profile that I need to cut at 45 degrees now so that they meet at the corners. So yes, I 3D printed a jig. I'll spare you the actual cutting because I'm mindful of your time and not because I'm ashamed of how sketchy that was. Now I need to drill mounting holes, exactly 3D printed jigs. The jig for the second hole needs to be relative to the first hole, so I have a much better chance of them matching. If it would be relative to the edge, then yeah, we're not talking about those 45 degree cuts, alright? Just remember, precision is not the name of the game. My design for this was like November, no room for nuts. So in CAD I was like clicky clicky threaded holes, but yeah, now it's not that fun anymore. My wrist hurts like the December after. I think I spent at least an hour tapping there. Remember I mentioned edge lighting? I'm using an individually addressable RGB LED strip to have some freedom in colors and experiment a bit with light effects. A couple of things I need to pay attention to here: keeping the strip centered and having the right amount of slack in corners. Other than that, it's pretty straightforward. Okay, one last thing. I need a nice box for the mess of modules and wires. So back into Fusion for a little bit. I'll also add the logo of my band to the cover because I can. Or at least I hope my 0.6 nozzle will have enough resolution. Yes! Oh yeah! Better than I hoped for. For the bottom plate, I'm jigsaw cutting a piece of hardboard. I got pretty good at using the jigsaw while building my escape room games, and the skill doesn't seem to go away in time. The microcontroller will need to take a power cable in, so it needs to be stable enough for that. I'll use epoxy putty to stick it in place forever. One last missing piece to be able to attach the bottom board and call it a day is holes in the bottom board. I'm using some... not 3D printed jigs this time. I'm just using some acrylic paint on the holes, then transfer to the board, then drill away. Sweet! Let's move to functionality. Oh wait, did I mention the mess of wires? Meanwhile, I ordered the PCB from PCBWay to get everything together with zero wires. I also have mounting holes now, which I didn't have on the D1 Mini, and designing it took under 1 hour. So I'll clean that up, but it's gonna be after the gig. Also, big thank you to PCBWay for sponsoring this video. It makes it easier for me to sustain this channel, and they open up manufacturing possibilities. If you haven't checked them out, you should at PCBWay.com. Okay, my step sensor is pretty laggy, so I need to reduce the delay to a minimum. I can chop a huge amount already by taking the Arduino Button 2 library out of the loop. It's not meant for this, and I suspect it might even check for double clicks, so it's waiting a huge amount on the bouncing. Much, much smoother already. Then strip down all the delays in the code. Oh, I need to fix these seizures. The pedal will activate on the rising edge of the button, so the delay between relay clicks is not too relevant. I mean, see it here with 150 milliseconds delay. I cannot go lower than 20 milliseconds on the other hand. That's the debouncing of the pedal. The only other place where I can optimize is pressure threshold. Think about it in terms of kick drum. When you start the motion and when the beater hits the drum, the shorter the travel distance is, the less delay. Something similar is the time before starting to apply the pressure and reaching the threshold. I really think this is the best I can get out of it, so let's test this baby out. You know, not all heroes wear capes. Some wear pajamas, but still watch the video till the end. You are my personal heroes. And if you also subscribe to the channel, well, then you surely won't miss the next project. And trust me, well, maybe not the next, but it is one coming. Just subscribe. It's gonna be a cooler stage prop. It's an insanely cool stage prop. Okay? Just subscribe.
Catch you in the next one. Catch you in the next.